And we're back with episode 10 or something like that. I'm not exactly keeping track at this point. We are in need of getting our encounter at the area 1 of the East Province here, which I don't know how to get back to. We're kind of cut off by this big cliff, so we're just going to keep what? We can just find a Cyclozar? You okay there, buddy? Okay, he's okay. That'd be kind of cool. But at the same time, we kind of have a Cyclozar a little bit, sort of. A little bit worried about the trainers nearby here, given that the wild Pokemon are in their low 20s and we are not at that level. That's a little bit spooky. So I'm trying to find a way, our way to a Poke Center here to heal up our paralyzed Anhilo. I would like to get him unparalyzed so we could actually potentially battle with them. And here is our Poke Center. Hopefully this is also an area we could fly to, so we could hopefully get back and forth between these areas a little bit more easily now. It's a Snom, a ghost-type Snom. What can and can't things terrestrialize into? Okay. Poke Center, yes, let me heal my Pokemon, please. Thank you, thank you. Okay. So we actually have a full squad for the first time ever. That's kind of wild. That's a little bit wild. I'm a little bit nervous about it, but that's okay. How weak are we to grass? Not that weak. Weak to grass, neutral to grass, but could become resistant. Okay, we're fine. Electric, we're fine. Fire, we're fine. The other one is ground. Ground is weak to ground, weak to ground, weak to ground, weak to ground. That's a little scary. But now we have Anhilo, who is good against ground, so hopefully we'll be okay. Hey, don't think I don't see you. That little coin thing down there, let's go. I don't know what these Gimme Ghoul coins do. I've been finding them occasionally. I'll keep picking them up as I find them. Is this a new area? This is back into Province 1. So we could get the Tadpole thing. We don't need an electric type. We don't need a water type anymore either if it is a water type. Hard to say, hard to say. But let's look around a little bit. Let's just look around a little bit. We're in a new part of this area at the very least. And so hopefully anything spawns anywhere at all, ever. Okay, I'm kind of glancing at the map here to get an idea of where we're going. We could try to head towards the flag as we do this. Don't really have any interest in an Unpheasant here. Or that's not an Unpheasant, sorry. It is a... Okay, well, this is our encounter, because you jumped me out of nowhere. So you look like the female version of the pig thingy. Oink cologne. Okay, so, like, pig cologne? Is that what's going on here? I'm going to, if you're ground type, we're in a little bit of a dicey spot. Let's switch off into Anhilo here, but given that it is our strongest Pokemon, and okay, you know what? I don't actually mind having a Pokemon that is new and a bit random, because, you know, we ran into it. Whatever, it happens sometimes. Headbutt, that's gonna hurt. Holy, why do you do so much? That was a lot of damage. That was a lot of damage. I'm just scared about this thing being part ground. I have no reason to think it's part ground, but I know that it learns Mud Shot, right? Because ours learned Mud Shot. Who can take a hit here? Show me your summary here. Who's got the best defense? What is your defense like? Your defense is 27, 27, 22, 33 on Atarka, 33 on you. Okay, so maybe you could take a hit. What is Anhilo's? Anhilo's is only 27. Okay, so Anhilo's a little bit low on the defense, but pretty high on the HP. It looks like we could take a hit from on Neheb. Neheb should be able to handle this. So let's switch into Neheb, and then we'll hit it with an Incinerate or an Ember. Incinerate, neither one's going to kill it. I just worry if we burn it, things could get dicey. It's going to have Mud Shot. That's going to hurt. Ooh, you had to use it right now, huh? Nice dodge, Neheb. Nice dodge. Okay, there's no way a Mudshot one-shots me. I'm gonna just hit you with an Incinerate. Okay, back to the Headbutt. We eat that pretty well. Incinerate, that did nothing. That did nothing. Okay, so we're still kind of weak to ground, because, our water type doesn't take a hit very well. We're gonna heal up here because just because I want to see how much a Mudshot does if and when it does connect. Because I don't know if it's stab or not. I don't know if this thing's actually part ground. Okay. That scares me more than Mudshot. is your defense? 27? So you'll take the hit even worse than Angelo did. Oh, man. Oh, man. This is making me think it's part ground. This feels like it's going to be a stab dig coming out here. Okay, look. We can live it on Atarka because we have Sturdy. So we switch into Atarka. We take the hit. Switch back into Neheb. Hope it doesn't go for a dig again. But if it just goes for a dig again, we're in the same exact position. You know what? Do we have any X items that could help? I'm not messing around. I'm dropping an X defense. I'm dropping an X defense here. We can't throw a ball because it's underground. It'll miss. We can't attack it because it's underground. We'll miss. Throw an X defend out. Make sure that we live this hit. If it crits, we could still die. But okay. That's kind of spooky that our defense just got doubled and it did that much damage. That's a little scary to me. I'm going to hit you with an Ember because I actually wouldn't mind burning you at this point. You're faster than me. It's fine. We've got the X defend going. Mudshot crit would still really hurt. That's a crit. Burn? No burn. Okay, we're going to heal here just because the Mudshot crit scares me. Man, this thing is shockingly problematic for like it being the same level as us and it being a wild Pokemon. It's kind of wild. Okay, that's fine. As long as you don't crit, we're big chillin'. Hit you with an Ember again, because again, I wouldn't mind burning you. Okay, dig is annoying. Dig is annoying. Use Ember. I can't throw a ball here. So if I can't throw a ball, technically we attack second, but I'm still just scared enough of a crit dig one-shotting us that I'm going to heal just in case to give us the best chance of surviving that. I really don't want to lose Neheb. Okay, that's a totally fine amount of damage. The problem is, if it crits, it's going to do double that plus 50% on top of that. So that's a little scary. So now we throw a ball, because if it digs, then it would dodge the ball. Or sorry, it would dodge the attack that we used anyway. So that was not even close. Okay, gotcha, understood. Covet, that's fine. That was a lot of damage, actually. Holy. We're going to heal here, because the crit mudshot would kill us. I want to catch this thing because we need Pokemon because encounters are so few and far between that I feel like I can't afford to throw one away. But this is not easy. Which I'm okay with. I'm okay with the game not being easy. That was 20 damage in a non-crit version of Mudshot. Oh, man. Oh, man. We're going to heal again. Because, like, oh. I think a crit might just one-shot us then. So if it... That means it would normally do 40 damage. So if we're at 100% HP, we might live a crit mudshot. But that only happens if we're at 100% HP. But I have to get it an attack eventually. So we're going to go for an Ember here. Don't you dare crit me this one turn. Okay, thank goodness. Thank goodness. Okay, get you a little lower. If we burn it, it could be a little bit risky just because... then we could end up knocking it out while we try to catch it if it is going to be breaking out here. We're playing this nice and safe. We're playing this nice and smart. I'm not messing around. I'm done messing around with this game. Not that I was actually messing around before, but I am just playing a little scared still. Which I think is reasonable. Okay, Mudshot. Okay. God, so much damage. That was 22 damage that time. Oh, it means we can't live that. Okay. I'm just stuck in a cycle of healing here until he uses Dig. But again, like if a crit mudshot knocks us out regardless, then there's no point in sitting here and healing when we're out of range of a non-crit mudshot. So let's just try to catch it. Because there's a good chance that a crit mudshot knocks us out from full regardless. So if we can just... Oh, I thought we had it. If we could just solve the problem right there, we'd be good. Okay, now you dig. So now we definitely heal because we can't attack it anyway. We can't try to start. We can't try to catch it anyway. So now we'll heal. Why is this thing so challenging? I wonder, are there any differences in the male and female ones other than just appearances? Or is it like actually a different type? Does it have different abilities? Is there anything more going on there? Okay. Dig did less than Mudshot by a pretty substantial amount. That's kind of surprising. We're going to hit you with an Incinerate here. It shouldn't do enough damage to knock you out. And I actually don't want to burn it at this stage. It's getting risky to burn it. Okay, there we go. Now we're going to try to catch you. I'm going to use a Great Ball because I want this to be caught so we can, you know, have one less turn to worry about a crit mudshot. And we're gonna see if this thing is part ground now, or if it just happens to have a bunch of ground type moves. And we have to decide if it comes onto the team. It probably does, just because our team could use the tankiness. Roar, we're not gonna learn Roar. There's no world in which we want to use Roar. Okay, and we could always relearn Roar if we wanted to. Cool. All right, let's take a look at this thing. It's just normal. So those were non-stab mud shots doing that much damage. My goodness. Okay, Oinkalone, you're gonna be named. Let's see. What's a good name for you? You're gonna be Cormella. E. L-A, okay. And I guess we'll put it in the box. It is nice that it can take a hit. Let's check it in summary. See what abilities it has, see what its stats are like. Special defense up. Okay, that's why we're doing like no damage to it, is it's got a lot of special defense. Okay, that explains a lot. It's a tanky Pokemon. We could use a bit of tankiness, but let's say add to our party and we'll think about who we would replace here. I like Zarium. I want to see if Zarium evolves. I like it. Atarka's just on the squad. On Hello's level 21. There's no way to go to that. I love Minsk. It'd be Isamaru, if anything. But Isamaru actually gives us some coverage and is also kind of tanky. I think it's actually okay to have Cormella in the box. I think that's a pretty good one for our box reset. I think it's an okay out. And so I'm curious how much of a difference there actually is between the versions there. If it's just appearance for gender, or if it's entirely different. I have to click A on it. I was sitting here waiting for something to happen. Okay, so these are all older Pokemon for some reason. Interesting. Okay, grab this. Poison Tail. We already know Poison Tail. That's okay. Let's go heal. Fly back here. This is the fire crew base. We want to go here, so let's fly here and hopefully make our way straighter to it. I keep getting lost. I apologize. it's a big open world, and I'm terrible with open world games because I get distracted and forget what I'm doing all the time. So it's just kind of the nature of the beast. All right, heal me up, please. Thank you. And I'm feeling okay. It feels like we're right around where we need to be level-wise, maybe a little bit low. I would really start to feel confident if we can get some evolutions to come through for our team. Let's take a look real quick and see what we have for experience items. It's a bit aggressive to use them now, but I'd rather use them now and get value than forget about it entirely. So let's see. Who's lowest on level? Let's give you some love. Give you half of these. That gave, like, nothing. And let's give you a couple of these. That actually levels you up. Sweet. Where did we go? Why have we disappeared? You're evolving. Okay, I was like, what is happening? We've just vanished. Okay, so level 18. That actually works out really well then. I would have been devastated if Zarium got knocked out right before that happened. Okay, you look almost the same, just a bit chonkier, which is still quite cute. And you are part fighting now. Interesting. Okay, that's actually pretty good. That adds some coverage to our squad. It does make us a little bit weaker to psychic, but that's okay. We have... Isamaru to help sort that out. We haven't been using charge. We don't need dig, right? Like we've got so many things. So actually now I'm actually really glad that we have the raised attack nature. That's pretty sweet. We have plenty of things that have ground type moves. We've got Atarka has ground type moves and Minsk have ground type moves. I don't think we need that coverage on this. I mean, what are we gonna be using dig against that we want you to be in more than anything? We could rare candy. We'll save the rare candy. There's a chance that we like just want to power something up later in the game. I don't think we need to be that aggressive on it. Okay, and we're gonna go to this thing. South Province Area 3. What? We could have had some of these guys? The Pompadour birds? I didn't know. Oh well. What are you? Oh, I know what you are. Okay, you're the bird. Yep. Something like that. I forget its name exactly. Okay, where are we going? Following this trail. Towards the flag. Hopefully this is the right way. This is not the right way. I can tell from the map this is not the right way. We want to go on the path here. Stick to this path and we'll be okay. Dude, I want this crab boy. I want this crab boy. He's just protecting that rookie D. He's probably rock, though it's hard to tell. And he was kind of scary. He hit like a truck. I thought that was one Pokemon. I saw like the Swink on top of the Shinx for just a moment there, and it looked like some weird like tiny dragon Pokemon. I was thrilled for just a brief moment there. Okay.
What?
Okay. Well, that's clearly the Titan Pokemon, right? Like, that's... Okay. I am mildly scared, considering how much damage a level 15 non-Titan one did. Okay. It's possible he's a rock water type. It's possible he's just rock. We have a fighting type now. We're gonna battle a small one and see how things go. See if we can suss out what type it is and maybe what its moveset might be like before we fight the big one. God, we're so much smaller than you. Oh, I gotta see. Hang on. Did our Terastallize type change? It is not. Okay, we are still electric there. So we're gonna hit you with an arm thrust and we're gonna see how much damage we do. Kaka. Did that last one do like actually no damage? Kaka. Okay. So this does surprisingly little damage, considering that we are 5 levels up and that's a stab move. Okay. We resist rock. That's actually great news. Maybe Zerium evolving is actually going to be super clutch for us for this Titan battle here. Because clearly we can't handle rock type very well with Neheb. We could potentially handle it with Minsk, but I'm worried if it's part water. It's just a crab. Like, it's not necessarily water. It's not giving me any evidence of being water, but it is a crab. So I think I've got to respect the water potentiality here. Okay, hang on. Arm thrust has like no PP, doesn't it? So that's a little bit unfortunate because we already used 2 and I'm worried we might need all of those. But let's prepare ourselves a little bit better here. Let's give you a... Hang on. It could go Oranberry. Oranberry could matter. We could also give it a Lepidberry if we do get low on arm thrusts. But let's give you an Oranberry. And let's give you an Oranberry. Because we now have a fighting type and a water type to go against this thing that we know is at least partially rock. I think we put out Anhilo, though. I don't know if it's rock water. If it's rock water, Anhilo is not as effective. But Anhilo will still resist. Actually, hang on. We don't resist with Anhilo. And Anhilo, we saw, can't take hits very well. So we're actually going to keep Zerium out front here. And you know what? You know what, Zerium? I'm counting on you here. I'm counting on you big time. So you're actually going to get that Rare Candy. We're going to give that Rare Candy. The level could make all the difference here. And I'm not messing around. Wants to learn Bite? You know what? Even better coverage. Let's go. Thundershock versus Nuzzle. Our attack is considerably higher. Thundershock is good. I think we're actually gonna... Do I pass on Bite? We have a Dark-type Pokemon in our party. Thundershock isn't great either, though. We'll get Spark soon, right? We're likely to get Spark soon. But Charge Thundershock is a lot of damage. We'll pass on Bite. We will pass on Bite. Okay, and then we're going to save our progress real quick, just because it's been a little while. And then we're going to battle this thing. Okay, see how it goes. He's vanished. Okay, hang on. We gotta go up the cliff after him. Okay, mildly spooked. I don't know how strong this thing's gonna be, but we've got some better typings for it now. Hello, sir. Please battle me. This is risky. That's kind of creepy. Just don't be level 25. You don't even have a level. First things first, we're gonna paralyze you. I'm very scared now. He can still be paralyzed. That's good. Okay. Gonna hit him with some arm thrusts. The Nuzzle actually did a pretty good bit of damage. It's not super effective, so it means he's probably not water. So he's rock. He's not rock ground. He might just be pure rock. Could be rock. He's probably not rock steel. He'd be taking more damage from these arm thrusts if he was rock steel. If that was doubly super effective. Okay. That's scary. Excuse me? Don't tell me it's every time I hit him. Every time you hit him, he gets attacked, and I just use an attack to hit four times? We're dead. We're so dead. We're so... Oh, thank God. Oh, thank God. There's a chance. Oh, my God. He got paralyzed. I think I just have to go for it, right? Even if he's going to get the benefit a bunch more, like... Oh, my goodness. That's terrifying. He has got two swords dances. And his special defense only fell once from all of that? Hit him again and hope we hit three times or more to knock him out. Okay, two will knock him out. Thank goodness. Okay, this is scary. This is very scary. We got a little lucky here. He's just gonna dip, huh? Interesting. Okay, so we don't actually not get to catch him. We have to chase him down and fight him more? No! We got so lucky that first time, though. I can't do it again. Maybe we go for the Dark Souls jumping attack, plunging attack, finishing move! It just killed me. I'm deceased. Okay, we aren't there anymore. Okay. Oh, it just killed me. Okay, that's the herb stuff that this guy's after. Nice, you found it? And that thing is a Stony Cliff Titan? No Koloff has any business being that big. Is it gonna grow even stronger now after eating those herbs? Oh god, I hope not. Let's watch ourselves nice. Oh no, we're gonna get bodied. We got so lucky with the last one. Oh no. Oh no. Okay, our boy's helping us. So there's a chance that they go for him instead. We're gonna Terastallize? Just because it's our best bet anyway, being Terastallized on Zerium, I believe. So we're just going to do this for a little bit of extra damage. Well, this is a little looking a little rough. Shelder, let's serve up a helping of defeat on the half shell. Okay, that's a bit of an odd line. I think it's an oyster, like how you eat oysters. You serve oysters on the half shell. It's also a line in the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles theme song. Okay. All right, see if we can get lucky again. I'm scared if when we hit it with a super effective attack, it gets stronger. That's a very scary prospect. That did a good bit of damage, though. We are Terastallized this time, so it makes sense we do more. But I am still mildly spooked. No, you're gonna make it stronger, Shelder. Don't hit me. Why are you hitting me? That didn't do that much damage, that's okay. Okay. Why did it get stronger that one time? Is it just when he drops below a certain amount of HP that it happens? I'm just going to hit him. I'm going to hope for the best. A chance he doesn't... Okay, there's a chance he doesn't go for me. And there's a chance that... I was going to say there's a chance this knocks him out. That does not seem likely right now. That was unlucky to get two. Because Anger Shell attack goes up. Attack goes up. Attack goes up. What is happening? Okay. Okay, so his defenses fell, but his attack, like, tripled. Okay, he went for Shelder, thank goodness. That didn't do that much damage. Okay, his defenses are down now. Shelder should do a good bit of damage here. And if we hit at least twice, we knock it out? Sorry, not at least twice, at least three times. As long as we don't hit twice, I think we knock it out. It could live on a tiny bit here. Okay. This thing was scary, man. Oh, my goodness. This is spooky. Oh, man. Like, the trial Pokemon were really hard in Sun and Moon, because, like, they gained so many stats that they could just knock you out of nowhere and just sweep your team. Luckily, the clutch level up for Zerium to get him the fighting type before we fought this gave me a lot of extra confidence going into this. So that's good. Whew, alright. Alright, look at my little buddy coming through like a champ. Alright, thank you, Mr. Manchild. But these Titan Pokemon are, yeesh, I sure don't like having something so tough out to get me. All right. Does he have a giant thing of chalk in his side pouch there? Is that what that is? I bet somewhere in here there's more of that Herba Mystica the Titan was eating. Quick, let's have a look around before it comes back. Before it comes back, I thought we destroyed it. I thought we were eating crab tonight. I thought we were going to have a big old crab picnic, but apparently not. Okay, all right. One gym down, one Titan Pokemon down. Watch your step. It's pretty dark. Okay, got a Pokeball. Huh? No way! Okay, there we go. We found some Herba Mystica. This is one of the Herba Mystica. It's exactly how it looked in the book. All right, the sweet Herba Mystica. Interesting. Yes, we actually found one. And it's all thanks to you, Nice. Now then, let's see. What does the book have to say? It says here that the sweet Herba Mystica is good for gut health and it helps aid digestion. Says it's great for stomach aches too, or when you want to stimulate the old appetite. That sounds useless to me. Now if I can just get him to eat some. Alright, now it's my turn to show off what I can do. You're about to get a taste of my great cooking. Okay, sounds good. Yeah! Yeah! Whatcha! Yeah! That is odd cooking noises, sir. I don't know what you're doing there. Here you go. An Arvin original sandwich packed full of herbs. I'll even give you a badge, you know, as a thank you for taking on that Titan Pokemon. You're allowed to give badges? You're a student. What? Okay, sure. I guess he just makes his own little badges and he's just like, here you go, have a badge. He actually made it himself. Okay, cool. I call it a Titan badge. Made it myself using a replica of gym badges, see? Okay, cool. So I wonder if we feed that to Miraidon and maybe that'll let it slowly get its original power back. And then it'll be stronger? We're just gonna eat it. Sure, why not? Okay, there we go. Yep, he's gonna come out and eat it. That makes sense. Agya! What's up with this thing? It just comes out of its ball on its own whenever it wants. Gonna give it a sandwich? Sniff, sniff. Hey, no! That's not for you! Grrr. Yeah, we'll give our sandwich to Miraidon. Here you go, buddy. Here you go. Chomp, chomp, snarf, chomp. Hey, I went through all the trouble of making that for you and you just give it away? Sorry, buddy. He likes sandwiches and I'm immortal and don't need to eat. So, I hope you realize that's all there was. So now there's none left for you. That's totally fine. Oh, come on now. Now you're making me feel all like I'm the selfish jerk here. Here, you can have half of mine, but you'd better savor every last bite. Gya-gya! Huh? You already ate that whole thing? Ooh, there we go, getting some of your power back. Agyas! We'll be able to die. So that's how we level it up. Okay, so that's how we get stronger and lets us start to get over new biomes. That's pretty good. Where are you looking, sir? What are you doing? It's directly in front of you. Hey, is it me or is that thing sort of powered up somehow? Agya! Whoa, I can't believe it. The power of these herbs is really worth guarding. If they had that big of an effect on your Pokemon, then I bet. I bet it'll come in super handy for that treasure hunt assignment we've got. Yep, that's what I bet. Well, you've both filled your bellies with some of my legendary sandwiches. Guess it's time to tidy up everything. So I'm wondering, is he, like, taking care of the other version of this legendary somewhere? And he's trying to, like, heal it? He said something started with M-A. He was, like, talking about something for capital M-A, and then he cut himself off and said, something else. And so we are a Miraidon. Is there a Ma-Ridon or something? Or is there some other thing? He's got something going on. And other than being a little sussy man-child, he's a bit sketch in other ways, too. Oh, you don't have to worry about helping. After battling the Titan, you've earned a break. That's probably a good point, I guess. Just leave this all to me. I'd be much obliged if you'd get a start on searching out the remaining four Herba Mystica for us. Okay, there's only four of them. Interesting. Only five total. Okay. I think we got lucky with the typing on that one, and we got very lucky that first time that we battled it, that it got paralyzed and didn't just bop us out of nowhere. I really owe ya. Dot, dot, dot. Okay, the coast is clear. You can come out now. Sus. Sus. I don't trust this big creepy man child boy. He says he's in our class. He's giving us badges. He's ordering us around. He's got secrets. What a sussy boy. All right. Rototototo. Hello, nice. This is Turo. He's going to have a regular voice because he's just a guy. I detect Maridon has gained some of its original power. It seems it will now be able to dash at high speeds while you're riding upon it. We can move faster. Let's go. It'll probably be framier as heck, but that's fine. But watch out for trees when dashing at high speeds. If you strike a tree while dashing, Pokemon lurking in the branches will fall down, allowing you to battle them. Okay, so that sounds like we could potentially do that. Your route is not fixed, but open before you. Seek out your own path using your map and the tools you have at hand. Whenever you find your curiosity piqued, you should go and explore as your heart desires. All that experience will help you grow in some way, great or small. Okay. Go forth on your journey and take good care of Maridon for me. Okay. We're going back in the cave. We can't go back in the cave? There was a Pokeball sitting in the middle of the cave. I want to get it. I want to see what it was. Okay, well. Let's... That thing's up there. Okay, never mind. I was going to say, let's real quick just take a look and see what this dragon type thing is. Let's take a look at our map. How are we doing on time? Okay, we're going to wrap up a little soon here, but we'll at least come up with a plan maybe for our next adventure so we can have a little bit more direction. We could go try to battle the grass type gym leader. Maybe I'll grind us up a little bit before the next one. I feel like we're right about where we want to be though, so I'm not super worried about it. Though this is Artisan West. This is all... So we've gotten... We never found anything in South Province Area 5, did we? I don't think we did. So let's maybe start off next episode with checking out Area 5, see what we can find. So we're going to fly to here, heal up a little bit, and then be ready to go for the next one. And we'll probably start off with a bit of a encounter here. And maybe look at grinding up a little bit. I feel like we're in an okay spot right now, but without Whooper or Nasli, evolving yet, it definitely feels like a little bit weak. Isamaro's got some decent stats, so I'm not super worried about him needing to evolve or anything. I was like, what is this Wi-Fi symbol on Whooper? It's just in the background. So, hang on, let's get ourselves to the next region. You know what, maybe we're not out of time yet. If we can find our way to the... If we can find our way to the fifth region... It's over here? How in the world do we get over there? Is this included? Let's just go out to the left. Go like down to the left and see what it tells us the region is. Where are we here? Ooh, that's a big fall. It said we could dash. Okay, there we go. Loving that. We can definitely get around a little bit. No, now we can go places with no problem. And we jump. Might jump a tiny bit farther while dashing, but not considerably enough for me to... Okay, we're not a new region. We have this is still Area 3. We'll probably just run away from this thing. Okay, and go on our merry way. Wild Pokemon being level 16 around here does make me slightly nervous about the overall power level of wild Pokemon here. There's the crazy Dunsparce that I definitely do not want to fight. If I get shellacked by a Dunsparce, I will never live it down. Okay, camera works a little bit odd while we're sprinting here. So this is dicey. Oh, okay, that's right. I'm trying to remember where we went where we found Area 5. I think it was somewhere around here, right? Not necessarily around here, but maybe up and to the right. Area 5, we found it. All right, cool. So let's look around a little bit as we end this episode here. Let's stop dashing. I don't want to dash anymore. Thank you. I will dash into a Pokemon accidentally. So we're going to look around a little bit. I think that's probably an okay thing to do at the end of an episode. So let's wrap around, you know, might not get the encounter here, but we'll at least get an idea of what we're looking for. And then maybe we'll make the decision at the beginning of the next episode if we end up looking around for too long. So I wouldn't blame you if you tuned out at the end here because it's not the most exciting part of the game. But if you're sticking around, sweet. Appreciate it. And having a good time still. Hyper Potion and Potion right next to each other. Kind of wild. Okay. So we gotta make sure to stay in Region 5. Region 5 so far seems the smallest of what we've seen. But then again, I could be wrong, or I could be completely right. Because it does feel a little smallish here. So let's go back into 5 and see if there's not something. Did we go down towards the coast in region 5 before? Woo! We're immortal, it's fine. We definitely don't want to go. We could actually re-encounter that because we already have an evolved form of it, so it's not a worrisome thing to run into that. But let's keep looking around a little bit more. I want something new. I want something cool. I want something that makes me feel a little something-something. You know what I'm saying? Let's go down here. Let's go down towards the water. Maybe that was a mistake. Hang on. Let's go up this ladder. See where that takes us. Okay, get off. Climb this ladder. Okay. Get a little bit of a look around from the higher view here. Little bird's eye view. I mean, a Rookidee or a... It evolves into Corviknight. I don't remember what the middle stage is called. That one's escaping me. Ooh, no! Why couldn't you be in the new area? You look cool! You make me feel something! No, I want you! Can I push you down the cliff, please? Oh, no. Okay, well, we can't catch this, but I do want to see what it is. It looks like a fire type? You definitely look like a fire type. I kind of like you. A Char Cadet. Okay, so you're like a fire knight. That's kind of cool. Are you weak to fighting? No. Okay. So I thought maybe it was like fire rock or fire steel because it's got like some armor design looking thing going on. Ember. So you're definitely fire type. So we don't need a fire type, but you got a cool looking design. And I'm curious as to what you look like when you level up. So that's a definite possibility. If we find one of those in the area 5, I would be totally down to check out a Charcadet. I'm so sad. Like, literally, it was just, like, the difference of, like, a little bit of elevation. I guess we couldn't get there. Okay, so let's go across this bridge. So we're in Area 3 again, for sure. Okay, I recognize Area 3 now. Can we not go across this? We can't across that? To Artisan via shortcut. Okay. I remember going in here before. Mildly lost again. How do we come up in a completely different area? We didn't. This is just where we climbed up? This is where we climbed up. Okay, so I want to go up that. I want to go over that little stone bridge thing. But I don't know if it's possible for me to get back up there from this direction, unfortunately. We will try, though. We will try. Man, the terrain here is a little confusing. So we're in Area 5. Now we're in Area 3. Okay, it's going to be tough to find. Yikes! Okay. Well, didn't mean to fall off of that. That's unfortunate. How do we get back up there? How do we get back up there? I do not know. I do not know. That's not the jump button. I was gonna try to jump up on that thing. I was like, now that we can dash, maybe I have the height to jump up on this thing. Nope, definitely not. Definitely not. Okay. So we went over here. And then... Keep falling down things. I'm never going to make it back up. I'm never going to make it to Area 5 again. I'm so lost again. Now I'm just completely lost. Now I'm found again. Okay, hang on. Please. Go up. Need a bird's eye view. Oh, hey. TM, let's go. Flash cannon. Ooh, that's a good TM. Okay, we're in Area 3 again. We never made it back to Area 5. Over here is Area 5, but I need to get up there. I can't do that from this side, can I? Hang on. So we go here, fly here, and we're going to go try to follow elevation up into the left a little bit. We're definitely running. This episode's going so long. You know what? Have we battled enough people to make you happy yet? We probably only battled 2. 5 trainers. You need 6. Okay, well, we'll battle one more trainer then as soon as we find them. So we want to go up and around. Gonna be a little bit of a longer episode, but again, you know, if I'm doing slightly more mundane things at the end of the episode, I don't think it's the worst thing for it to be a little bit longer. Okay, now we're back in Area 5 again, so we gotta keep an eye out for Pokemon. Okay, and I want to stay high and go on this bridge thing. Is this the bridge thing that I was talking about? No, there it is. There we go. This looks like it connects to another thing. Okay, there's also a trainer over here. Okay, well, you know what? We'll call this episode done there, then. We'll battle this trainer afterwards, at the beginning of the next episode, and we will auto-heal Zerium here, just to make sure we're good. They're a hiker, so they're likely to have ground and rock types, which means that maybe Onhilo can get a little bit of love. Onhilo doesn't need the levels, though. Maybe Minsk can get a little bit of love. A little bit weak to ground, but that's okay. I think Minsk will be all right. So let's look at maybe getting Minsk out there. That'll do it for this episode, though. Hopefully you enjoyed it. A little bit long, that's okay. I'm starting to go for a little bit longer episodes just so we can get more flow going, hopefully. And that'll do it for now. If you enjoyed it, awesome, and I hope to see you in the next one.